So when we talk about the weighted average number of shares outstanding, we're going to treat stock dividends, stock splits, stock subscriptions, delayed issuance of stocks. All of those are going to be traded as if they've been outstanding for the whole year. So we'll kind of talk that, you know, in a sense, retroactively or retrospectively as of the beginning of the year. So this is the thing called weighted average number of shares outstanding. So what I want to do is talk about what does weighted average number of shares outstanding mean. Let's look at that. So to do that, you'll see that there is an example in your notes for weighted average number of shares outstanding. So I'm going to put here a 1 weighted average number common stock outstanding. That's where we're going to do this formula. So on average, how many shares are outstanding? Now, let's say, for example, on January 1st, I have 100,000 shares of common stock outstanding, and you'll see this in your notes. On April Fool's Day, another 80,000 shares are issued. On July 1st, a 10% stock dividend. And the 10% stock dividend is issued. Then on 9/1, 18,000 shares of treasury stock are repurchased. Now, what does that mean? That means of the 100, 18 is not outstanding for 9, 10, 11, 12, 4/12 of the year, right? And you're allowed to bring your fingers to the exam. You can use those. Then on December 31st, let's do a 2-4-1 stock split. Now, the key here is dividends and splits are done how? Retroactively. In other words, as if they happened at the beginning of the year. Dividends and splits are done how? Retroactively. As if they were done at the beginning of the year. Okay. So, how many shares do we have outstanding? What is our weighted average? Now remember, weighted average is different than shares outstanding, because you may have the share outstanding, but on average it wasn't outstanding the whole year. So on average, so that's why we're trying to divide it by not shares outstanding, but the weighted average shares outstanding. In other words, if I have 100,000 shares outstanding on January 1st, how many do I have outstanding the whole year? 100,000. What's weighted average? 100,000. But if I had 100,000 outstanding all year and 50,000 outstanding for half a year, the 50,000 isn't 50, it's 50,000 for half a year, it's 25,000. Oh, because on average, it's as if you had 25 all year if you had 50 for half a year. Let's try it. So 100,000 outstanding, that's going to be for 12/12, which is 100,000. Then on 80,000 is outstanding for how much of the year? Well, it's April Fool's Day. That means it's not outstanding for 3/12, so it's outstanding for 9/12, which is 60,000. That's 160,000 so far, 160,000. Then on July 1st, 10% stock dividend, what does that mean? It means you go back and everything outstanding gets 10% more. So in a sense, what you can do is you can add the 10% retroactive, which is another 16,000 shares. So that's 16. As if it went all the way back. So you're just adding. So you can either take this, 100 plus 10% is 110, 60 plus 10% is 6, there's your 16. Okay, because you're adding 10, you're adding 6. That's 16, boom. Now, this one's tricky. 18 of the 100 were not outstanding for what? 9, now careful, this was not on 9/30, it was 9/1. So all of 9, all of 10, all of 11, all of 12, which means that 18,000 shares were not outstanding for 4/12 of the year. So 18 at 4/12 is 6,000. That's shares that are not outstanding. In other words, you would not have to pay stock, you would not have to pay a dividend to those because those shares were not outstanding for that portion of the year. That gives me 160 plus 176, 170. Then on December 31st, stock splits are treated what? Everything above it, you hit it. So times 2 gives you 340. So 340 represents what? The weighted average number of shares outstanding. However, how many shares are really outstanding? You've got really 100 plus 80 plus another 18, 10%, minus 18 times 2 is 360,000 shares outstanding. This is weighted average outstanding. This is just outstanding. So how many shares do I have really outstanding? I have 100 plus 80. Notice I add all 80 in. Why? Because I don't care how much of the year, it's just still outstanding at the end of the year. But of the 180, 18 were not outstanding, but we still have to add a 10% dividend to those. That's adding in 180, 18, 10%, taking out 18, you end up with 180. And then 2 for 1 is 180 times 2. So if you took the 180 times 2 is 360. So this is outstanding. This is weighted average outstanding. So why do we care? Because this is the number that goes here. How much weighted average? 340. So you take net income minus preferred. What is the rule on preferred? If it's cumulative, take it out, whether declared or not. If it's non-cumulative, only if declared. Then you take that divided by the weighted average number of common stock outstanding. So let's look in our notes. It says weighted average number of shares outstanding. That is the denominator. There's another example. We issued on 1-1, 500. We issued on July 1st, 100. We issued on 10-1, another 300. So what is that? The 500 were issued, were outstanding for the whole year, so that's 500 times 12 twelfths. Then we had 100 was issued on July 1st, that's 100 at 6 twelfths. Then we issued 300, and they were only outstanding 10, 11, 12 is 3 twelfths, which is 75, 5, 50, that's 625. So you can see that once you kind of understand the basics, it's not too bad to calculate, okay? It says in your notes, the reason for prorating the shares is that they're only available for productive use by the corp from that point on, not the entire year. This would not be the case, however, if they're retroactive, stock dividends, stock splits, delayed issuance of earlier consideration, or stock subscriptions. In these cases, shares are treated as if they were always outstanding or included in the full amount for the current year. They're also included for earlier years that are shown in comparative purposes. In this case, a reverse stock split, these would retroactively reduce shares. So in a stock reverse, what is a stock split? 2 for 1. What's a reverse stock split? 1 for 2, goes the other way. But here's the key. Comparative, that's an important point. So what it says is this. If we were to go back to the previous year, then you'd have to go back 10% as well for this dividend and still go back and do a 2-for-1 split. Because you got to compare apples to apples, not apples to oranges. Otherwise, you get mixed juice. All right. You'll see that example in the notes so that you understand. And the example I gave you is a little bit more difficult. It's a little trickier. And that example I gave you that comes out to 340, I wanted to throw in there the dividends, I wanted to throw in there the splits, and I wanted to throw in there also the treasury stock, because that has been tested, and that basically comes off of the shares that you had available. So, what is basic or simple? It's net income minus preferred dividends is the dollars available, divided by the weighted average number of shares outstanding. How do you calculate that? You look at how many were outstanding for the whole year, you weight them for part of the year. If there's a dividend or split, go back and hit everything, including the previous year. If there's a stock split, go back, including the previous years. If there's treasury stock, that represents the 100,000 that was not outstanding for what portion, and you take that out. Okay, so that's really the basic calculation. That's what's important to understand, especially as we're trying to start out, especially as we're trying to understand the basics of it. What we're going to do in a minute is then take this basic and go to the next step, which is a complex or diluted. Because this talks about, okay, let's assume there is stuff that's potentially diluted. Let's assume there are things that are converted. What is that? Convertible bonds, convertible preferred stock, options, rights, warrants, all these other types of transactions and instruments. Those are other instruments that will affect earnings per share. We will see that in just a minute.